Un attimo, ecco. any chaps on the way in?
Until that's finished. So what I'd like, just for appearance on the streaming, if a load of you can stand along the back of these tables, facing that way, then as soon as we've finished, you can get away to your matches. Appreciate that, thanks.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the World Eightball Pool Championship here at the Imperial Hotel in Blackpool. An early morning kickoff, and we have two matches now. The ladies' single semi-finals on table one. Will you please give it up for the referee, Matt Ward? The contestants from England, Sharon James. Her opponent, world reigning champion from England, Amy Beauchamp. And on table two, the referee for the match, give up for Lloyd Clark. The contestants in the ladies' single semi-final on table two, give up for Anne Louise Arkle from England. Number two seed from England, a warm welcome to Barbara Taylor. Right, referees, commence the games.
On tables 3 and 12, France and England. On 13, 14, Reunion Island, India. 4 and 11, Malta, Wales. 5 and 6, Scotland, Ireland. 9 and 10, Mauritius. And 7 and 8, South Africa, Northern Ireland. Thank you.
Thank you. frame, and Louise to break. Time running. Mark Botti.
She's played that exceptionally well because she's finished up behind these two reds, and her red ball she's promoted to the top right hand pocket. Okay, it's not as good of a promotion as she would have liked, but it's still out in the open, and very potable if she gets her white down to that end of the table. And she's left her opponent, her opponent can get. Had to play that ball down the rail, which it's a great shot. It's even fallen. It was quite a difficult shot to play, but she's played it exceptionally well. And that's that's the sort of shot you need if you're going to win these type of finals, because that's created a big opportunity for her to get in and clear this table if she's in form this morning. She'd probably be thinking that that looks fairly, I don't like to use the word elementary out, but it's the sort of out that these players will normally make 9 times out of 10. But we won't try and put the knockers at all, just watch as she goes through the motions of potting these balls. I'm sure she's probably a little bit nervous this morning. For his dad, Barbara Taylor, I'm sure she's as calm as a cucumber. She's left herself an angle on this yellow, so she'll be able to go around to try and get on the black to put it back in this bottom right hand pocket. She's leaning over the table, that's fine, she's just reaching a little bit. So she's having to go across the table. I thought that she would be able to, from the previous angle, I thought that she'd be able to get that yellow in its bottom right, but unfortunately she had to play across the table, and you saw the result. She's run into the red of Barbara Taylor's and now given 2 shots away. So it's not easy, but Barbara Taylor with 2 shots should be able to clear these 3 reds and the black and win her first frame. And of course this match is best of 13 frames, which means that it's a race to 7. So Barbara just chosen to break those 2 balls, not try anything fancy of a plant at an angle to try and pop one of them, just simply broken them up. So now she's going to be left with simply potting one at a time, no misses, and try to chalk up the first frame in this semi-final in the ladies individual singles event here at the 2018 World Championships. So she's just gone across. Of course, this is the World 8 Ball Pool Federation Championships, played under World 8 Ball Pool Federation rules. So she's surveying the table. Just wonder whether she's got any angle there to be able to get across to that red down the table. I think she has, so we're gonna, that's it, yeah, I thought she'd stun across. She would have liked to have gone a little bit further, but I believe that's enough, and in some ways it's good because she's got quite a generous angle in order to come back on this black. But it needs to be a good. No, she doesn't want to risk it. She doesn't want to have a go at this stage this morning. So it looks like Anna Louise is going to be a little bit game here, and she's going to play off the cushion, I suspect. And sometimes if you can get the right angle off the cushion, off 2 cushions, as the white bounces off that second cushion, you might be able to shave that black into the pocket. But let's see how Anna Louise does it here. That's a great shot. Oh, disaster. That's unfortunate. That's a beautiful shot played by Anna Louise, but very unfortunate to go in off and give Barbara Taylor the first frame. It's got she's got to take the positive out of that. She played that shot beautifully. Didn't play off any 2 cushions like I was suggesting she might. In fact, she played it picked the angle to play directly off 1 cushion and pot that black. But yeah, I guess it's fortunate that it's happened at this stage of the match and it's not at a more critical one, but still it's heartbreaking when you play such a good shot and you find that you're going in off and giving your opponent the frame. So we've got Lloyd Clark, the referee, racking up the balls here. Let's see how he goes and whether he has any trouble getting the balls to stick, because these players like for the all the balls to be making contact. Satisfied that all the balls are ready to go. Barbara doesn't seem to be too perturbed. She just takes a white ball and she's going to break. That's a great shot. And she's managed to pot a red. And those reds are sitting quite nicely. You can certainly make the first pot on the red. They're all out in the open. Just the black will need some sort of promotion at some stage. It does come in the bottom middle. That's an awkward position. So I think she can get past that yellow and pot this red closest to the left, bottom left pocket. That's what she's looking at. And once she's played the shot, you can see that that wasn't quite possible. So what she did is she just played a defensive shot. And left it as tight as possible. So Barbara Taylor's on the red balls. And Anne-Louise Arkle is on the yellows. Just basically promoted a few balls there, but I think Barbara Taylor's left wide open here. She can start doing the business, I believe, in this frame. So she's taken that easy ball over the bottom right-hand pocket first. She's surveying the lie of the table. She's going to try and take this red into the left middle, I suspect. And that's the way she's queuing up. Made that nicely and just to hold her white. It's the way she's, she must be feeling a little bit tight the way she's swinging that arm. She probably wanted to play that a little bit firmer and make her white come out from those two cushions. Maybe doesn't like the bridge over the pocket. She's got this red into the middle again. Played that one a bit firmer. Now it's starting to get a little bit harder. I think she's left a very fine cut on this first red, the way she's looking, or the second red up the table she can put in the top left hand. I think she'll possibly take that one first. I don't think she'll be too keen on that fine cut. We'll see the way she lines up. It looks like she's lining up for the... that's the one. And she's come back nicely for the red into the middle. So she'll be... and got a really nice angle to take the red in the middle. And then also work her white back off that cushion to be on the red in the bottom right hand pocket. There, she must have put a little bit aside and made that white work off the cushion towards this red, which is going to run down in the bottom right hand pocket. And of course she's also got a really nice angle to get herself closer to the black. Try and take a 2-0 lead in this match. Let's have a good look at it, because concentration. It's very important to hold your concentration right throughout a match. Done that nice and steady and finished up nicely on the black. Probably would have liked to have gone a little bit further to be a bit straighter on that black into the middle. But still, it's quite a negotiable angle. As you can see the various camera angles. That sort of gives you an idea of the cut that she's got to play in order to get it into the middle pocket. And Barbara Taylor does that very nicely. She's hit a little bit of early form here, and she's leading 2-0. Apart from, of course, Anne did fail on that first black, but Barbara Taylor is playing very steadily. And this is the type of play that's given Barbara Taylor so much success over the years. And we'll see how it progresses and whether she's able to maintain that form. And of course, we hope that Ana Luise can show us the sort of form that's got her to this semi-final so that we can have a tight match befitting of a semi-final. So, Barbara Taylor, 2. Ana Luise Arkell of England, 0. Both these girls from England. And these are the 2018 World Championships Ladies Individual Semi-Finals coming to you from the Imperial Hotel here in Blackpool, England, as the referee racks up the balls again. Gives them one last push, touch, to try and make sure that all the balls are touching. He'll pick up his timer.
Second frame.
Pick up the white ball and gives it to the incoming player, which is Ana Luise Arkell, who's going to break. And that's a nice break. She's managed, nearly pots the black off the break as well. But she's managed to pot a red ball. And so now she's got to determine what her preference is. She must nominate. When you pot a ball off the break, you must nominate which colour you're going to play next, or which one you... If you don't, it's a foul, and you give your opponent 2 shots. So it looks like she's potted reds. She must have nominated reds. It's a nice pot there. She's pulled that ball with some good conviction, nice and confident. That's what you need to do. Nice to get that free-flowing arm nice and early. She kind of, that was a miss looking to happen then. She had the cue at 45 degree angle to the table, possibly the way she needed to bridge. And so Barbara's coming in now, but at least she's actually covered that yellow from going into the bottom left hand pocket. So the yellow nearest this bottom cushion, you'll see, is prevented from going into that pocket, although a good shot off the cushion into it may promote it to the pocket. But Barbara's just played a defensive shot. She's tried to get that yellow close to the middle pocket and stay as close as possible to that yellow top left of screen. Try and cut that red into the right hand middle pocket. Yeah, she plays that very nicely. And she's, I believe that red, there's a red that goes into the bottom right hand corner too, I believe, or at least if you can run it past and you could take command of this pocket. So it's one of those in or over shots that I'd be playing. I've got that other red which is close to then the next red, which is closest to bottom ball, close to the two yellows. Don't think that goes in between cushion and black. So in her mind, all these things will be going through her mind and working out how she's going to promote these balls. So she's taken that pot quite firm and with conviction. She's playing some of these pots with quite a strong, smooth line float, as if she's trying to play herself into the game and build confidence, which is always nice to see. Doing the same again there, but didn't quite execute well enough. And she would have been in a position to possibly try and play that red, cushion off the black into the middle. But we'll see what happens at a later stage with that red. Yeah, that's the shot that I was talking about earlier that Barbara Taylor might play on that yellow. Executed exceptionally well. Where you can squeeze through between cushion and ball, and the ball actually helps you. The other ball actually helps direct the yellow to the pocket. It's a nice shot across the table to take command of that pocket. That kind of delays Barbara Taylor with those two balls that are potable and playable towards this bottom right hand pocket. Quite often a strategy of these rules. So Barbara just promotes that yellow to make it potable into the middle. It also leaves it relatively tight, only restricts her opponent to having a shot at that red, which certainly can't be potted into the into that top left hand pocket. So the red comes across. Not sure whether she was trying to pot it or not, but I think she's probably in some ways pleased that it didn't pot. So Barbara Taylor, what can she do here? She'll, while she's got the opportunity to be close to that yellow, she probably, I thought she would try and run it to the top right hand pocket, but no, she's played another tight shot on her opponent. Making it very difficult for her opponent. On the reds. She can probably go through those two, but all she can do is just hit that red and maybe at least promote it away from that position, because it's pretty awkward to pot where it is. And she in fact has tried to give it an opportunity to go somewhere. So at least now it's in the middle of the table for her. Taylor's got to negotiate these two yellows that are close to these two reds as well. So in the meantime, she's playing this yellow to the top right hand corner. She'll probably play the plant here of that yellow onto the yellow that's out of the middle pocket. Doesn't want to make a mistake and play it onto the black, but so she's leaving that shot alone for the time being. She's happy to take the easy ball and thinks it's a better idea to maybe get onto it from that side, so she can take the yellow, which is closest to black, first into the middle. Push the black safe for the time being, because she's got two safe balls. In the meantime, I I think she would have liked that white to stay on the yellow into the middle, but it's not so bad. She can still promote that. Well, there is a very fine cut on it, but she's going to go and start clearing. Actually, when you look at it from above with this shot, you can plant the yellow between. She's not trying anything fancy like that. She's just getting her yellows amongst it there. So she's prevented that second red in this area from plant being able to play a plant onto the red over the pocket. And it's quite workable, this corner, yet, because that red is right in the middle of the pocket, so there's gaps on both sides of that red. So Anne Louise, and I, from where I sit from above, it looked like that red couldn't go past the yellow, but that clearly proved it could. So she's going to take this now and somehow maybe try and find her way to the red in the middle of the table. No, just playing safe. This is why they're playing in the semi-final, and I'm here trying to commentate. But I still enjoy it. We love bringing this coverage to you, wherever you are watching around the world. I'm sure there's still plenty of viewers in the Southern Hemisphere, because it's still a reasonable time over there. The game is, I'm sure you all know, is very popular in Australia, and Australia loves coming to these World Championships every year. So I'm sure there'd be some viewers in Australia right at this moment, wherever you're watching in Australia. Big cheerio from Joe Fanto. So it's a foul shot played. It's a deliberate foul where she's pushed the yellow behind her red. And at the same time trying to make it very difficult for her opponent to clear, but trying to gain an advantage by making her opponent effectively clear that pocket for her and giving her a clear way to that that red. I guess the awkward part for Anna Louise under the current circumstances was that that red's over the pocket and the other red was in the middle, and she couldn't, I guess she couldn't see herself negotiating putting the red over the pocket and also getting onto the other red. So Barbara hasn't done anything flamboyant here. She's just nicked into her yellow. And now she's just going to play it away. I'm sure she was probably trying to finish in an area where Anne Louise would be more restricted on a shot on that red. Guess the other problem you've got here is that the black is on a cushion. She's queuing up as if she's going to take this on. She played that really nice. I think maybe that was intended to break into the black. Because now you can see she's actually snookered on her red, which is positioned close to this bottom right-hand pocket. But she should be able to negotiate her way out of this. I'm sure she's looking at the angles to maybe get out of this snooker and possibly even get very close to snooker and pull it back, playing with a couple of cushions. She's, you can see what she was trying to do, but unfortunately she's fouled, and this is a foul snooker as well, so her opponent, Barbara Taylor, can ask for ball in hand and take the ball back to book. So if she does, you you'll see the referee actually pick it up and hand it to her. The players shouldn't pick it up themselves. Have to wait for the referee to pick the ball up. So Barbara's taking. No, she's opted to simply play that red and return the. Turn the compliment with another foul. So, this is interesting. So it's our release. Again, she's faced with trying to think of, we can see that she's got the shot off this cushion to play into the red, but she could be trying to think of a more creative shot here that's going to set her up for winning the frame. So she's played the black into those two balls and tried to nudge that red forward a little bit. I think all that does is sort of congest the game, which makes makes it difficult for both these players to win this frame. So is she looking at potting this? And I was thinking she might be looking at potting it and coming around to try and break them, but no, she's playing very conservative and giving her opponent a long shot. So the referee here is Lloyd Clark. Of course, these players have 60 seconds to play a shot. At the end of 30 seconds, they get a 30-second warning. So they know they've only got 30 seconds left to play the shot. She's chosen to negotiate the snooker this time and actually play off the cushion and into the red and only give her opponent one shot. Barbara thinks she can sneak into there. I can't tell the shot she's playing here. So what she's done is she's actually played into her opponent's ball, but left it really restricted as to what she can do. Sometimes in these situations, I just wonder whether just playing right through that red and those balls and opening them right up might be the solution. She's just played a conservative shot. I don't think that was touching, otherwise she wouldn't have played that shot. That would mean that she just played into the red, made sure she doesn't give two shots to her opponent. Barbara Taylor might feel comfortable now to bring one of those yellow balls out. Sure whether she fouled and moved on that black. I'm pretty sure she would have nudged the yellow first and moved that black forward. So I can't imagine she would have given two shots away there, but she wouldn't have needed to for the shot that she wanted to play. The objective seemed to be to separate the black from this area. Just the slightest. This is turning out to be one of those frames which is tick for tack and a little bit of tactics and neither player wanting to give an inch. Not quite sure what was meant to be there, because if that's where you wanted the white to finish up, just put it, you could have just directly put it there. Maybe she was trying to play off the cushion to get onto her red and misjudge the angles on the cushions and jaw. So that's more likely to what happened. So Barbara Taylor, very pensive. Not in the mood for opening this frame up at all. That's a positive mood. She's potted that ball. I'd say she'll probably take that ball in the top left-hand corner as well. And maybe she thinks this now's the time that with two shots she's going to be able to separate those two yellows, break them, and that black certainly runs into that bottom right-hand pocket as well. Yeah, that's a nice controlled wipe because she's exactly where she wants to be. Barbara Taylor. Separate them, and the black of course has come out nicely as well, so she's just got that yellow which is up against the cushion. She can probably pot this yellow in the bottom left hand pocket, come off the two cushions and the other side of the yellow to bring the yellow into this bottom left hand pocket as well. Let's see if she plays that. She has attempted that shot, but I think she's fallen a little bit short for what she would have, how she would have liked. But that's still very much a reasonable angle to bring that yellow into this bottom left-hand pocket. And the white will simply play the cushions and should finish up in a position that black will go into the middle right pocket. Barbara Taylor, very experienced campaigner, been playing for many years for England and having great success as an individual. Unfortunately, she's missed that pot and now she's let her opponent in. Gamble didn't come off at this stage. And let's see what Anne Louise can do here. Now nice and steady. She's left herself nicely on this black. And Anne Louise Arkell of England wins her first frame in this ladies semi-final here at the 2018 World Championships. And Louise Arkell of England won, Barbara Taylor, the number two seed of England, 2. So Barbara Taylor still leads this match in its best of 13, which is a race to 7 here at these 2018 World Championships, coming to you from the Imperial Hotel here in Blackpool, England. You've just joined us. Welcome to the coverage. We're going to be giving you lots of coverage from these World Championships all day today and well into the evening tomorrow with all the finals being played tomorrow, the team finals, individual finals. And of course this morning you're watching the ladies individual semi-final. These championships have been going since last Wednesday, where the men's individual qualifiers commenced, and all's been going smoothly. Referee racking up the balls, and Lloyd Clark, the referee, has been having good success in getting those balls racked first time today. Having a look. I don't don't think he's needed to put the rack back on once as yet.
Two frames.
So this is Barbara Taylor to break. For you viewers at home, if you look at that white ball on the right, now that was an unusual situation there. Certainly looked like a foul break to me, so not this one, but Barbara Taylor, this must be Anna Louise to the table now, and she must have two shots, because I'm pretty sure that white went off the table. So this must be Anna Louise Arkell at the table with a good break and two shots, and I'm pretty sure a yellow has gone down. And reds have gone down as well, so it's quite a break. And she still has two shots in hand, so she'll be hoping that she can dish here. So it's a nice pot on it. She's put up both balls here. So by putting both balls when she was on yellows, that means Barbara Taylor now gets two shots. So quite a change in fortunes in this first frame. Pretty amazing. So Barbara's on reds. I'm sure she didn't expect to see herself in this situation after the break that she had. See if she can capitalise on this situation. So she's got that red in this bottom right hand corner, and she'll probably be able to go around. Of course, we can see in the distance that red close to the yellow, which might be awkward for her, but she's got the angle here to put that red in the middle, right middle pocket. And the white will go up the table, and she'll be able to run the red down to the bottom left-hand pocket. And of course, remembering that she's got two shots, she should be able to negotiate that red with two shots into the pocket, and then have a shot on black, except quite possibly there's another hiccup here. She's covering her eyes. I'm not sure if that means that she's snookered herself here. I suspect so. Yes, it looks like a snooker to me. So what a change of fortunes in this frame. It's changed about three times already. So she's got to negotiate her way out of a snooker, and that's come out nicely for her. And she's still got a shot to play, so she can take that red in the top right hand pocket and not do too much work with the white, and she'll be on that black in the bottom right hand pocket. She would probably play with a bit of bottom and stunner into the cushion. So we see a snooker played here. He plays that yellow into the cushion and leaves the white there for a quite a clear snooker. When you look at it, it looks like that white, that black is just out enough that you can actually hit a fine edge. But circling the table. Be trying to see if she can hit it in a way that gives it a chance to pot it. She's looking at that angle. She wants to try and get a good contact. And she's managed to make contact with the black, so she hasn't conceded two shots to her opponent. Straight on that yellow closest to the white into the top right hand corner. I think she'll stick to putting these two balls down the centre of the table, because she might have a mindset playing this yellow, which is close to where the spot is, where the black spot is. If we run through to try and get that white in the bottom left hand pocket. Sorry, the yellow into the bottom left hand pocket. She's left her white nicely, so she's got a good angle. Pop this yellow into the bottom left hand pocket, off the two cushions and onto that last yellow into the middle one. Of course, you can see where the black is, and that will go into the opposite middle pocket. That's nicely played, that's perfect. Perfect. So she, it's Anne-Louise Ackle. She's gently nudged that ball into the middle pocket. She's well in line with the black. Arkle levels the score here in Blackpool against Barbara Taylor. It's two frames all in the ladies' individual semi-final, the 2018 World Championships. Commentary. Yeah, there was quite a change of fortune in that frame. They both gave away the advantage early in the frame. It was the most amazing thing I saw from Barbara Taylor. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
And then she just went out of position on the last ball and left herself a tricky black.
Yeah, that's right.
Spare cue ball, and she was unhappy with her Q-tip.
Right, yeah, actually, I didn't notice. quite sad, but that's well observed.
Well, it's because when it happened, I was out in the main arena and I see her go up to the side and start doing it. So.
Right. So this is Anne-Louise Arkwood break. She sort of takes an extreme left. So she, I imagine she hits the second ball?
Yeah.
Yeah, she hit that second red. Got a good reaction, but I don't think she's got a ball this time.
And that's always the problem. That break, with the cut break, it opens it up.
It does.
If you don't make a ball, it's dollies.
Yeah. So it's Barbara Taylor at the table now. And as a result of that break,
you'd have to say you got to be looking here for.
I think at the moment Barbara Taylor's got a problem with the white ball. She wants it cleaned. So it's a little gadget that the referee's got that he pulls out of his pocket to try and make sure the white ball is going to go back in exactly its same spot. Very, very careful to not dislodge any other balls from where they are. So that operation is finished. Back to Barbara Taylor and her yellow balls. Well, that looks like what she wants to go for. They seem to be the best,
yeah.
Do they?
Yeah, I think it's top one is on now. Take these next. Take the top one, bottom one. Then you've just got to screw back naturally. And you're on for the middle. And from there it's just drawing up ducks.
That's the way.
Not
somehow I normally deviate from those dots when I'm playing. But yeah, these players sort of have a look at the table plan. They're trying to, I guess you embark on a plan to clear all the balls, and then you get on with it. So you see some players take their time right at the start and then try and get into a rhythm. Yeah. Unless, of course, they've run off track and they have to stop again for plan B.
I've just never thought of these players seeing doing.
Yeah, so how do you think Barbara's going here with her break? She's still on track, a little bit straight. But
all she's got to do is roll this in, she's got to roll up.
Yeah, well, she's got, yeah, exactly. Just a case of if she was hoping to get a little bit closer to that end of the table to make it a little bit easier. But for a player of Barbara's calibre, if she just rolls as yellow as you say, she shouldn't have any trouble with that next yellow.
It's the kind of shot you wouldn't bank her to miss.
Some new terminology here. That's a good shot. But, and where do you think she'll put the black?
It's got a double. Don't know if it goes in the middle, both middle pockets and the corner pocket.
Yeah.
I think it's just down where she feels comfortable just leaving it and playing it down into the corner, or if she wants to try and roll down towards the red and play it from the middle.
Yeah, the opposite middle? Or
yeah, the opposite middle.
If she's got the angle, that's where I'd probably want to play it.
It's just, it looks a little too straight.
Yes, and here it does. She likes the angle in the middle, but that's...
You can, then. I just think you've got more pocket to aim for going down to the corner.
Yeah. I guess it's a preference here for this shot, whichever one you feel more comfortable with.
Important shot now. She had this kind of opportunity in the last frame.
Yeah, she doesn't want to be missing too many of these opportunities at this level.
Should I go for the
beautifully, and Barbara Taylor, the number two seed, takes a 3-2 lead against Anne Louise Arkell in this ladies' individual semi-final. So, Leon, tell us a little bit about yourself. Whereabouts do you play your pool?
Berkshire area, and Dylan Leary's club.
Yeah.
So, have to practice with top guys pretty much most week.
Yeah. So you're here playing for the England side?
No, I'm just the World Singles and the World Masters, but right. I thought I'd have the second week as a holiday and get to watch the great pool at the same time.
Excellent, well done. So, I know you mentioned where you're from, but I don't have much idea of where that is in relation to Blackpool. Like, have you had to come far?
About a 4-hour train journey.
Wow.
London way.
Yeah, that's great. So you're dedicated. Yeah, and definitely, you're certainly going to watch some great pool the rest of today and tomorrow.
Well, we've got one of our local lads in the World semi-final later on today.
Right,
who's that? Mr. Eddie Barker.
Eddie Barker, yeah. He's certainly making a name for himself. So the referee, he's doing it pretty well this morning. He hasn't had to put the rack back on the balls at all. Been able to get it first time. So Barbara Taylor to break. She gets it all okay this time. She hits the head ball. Can you see anything missing? The yellows are all there. The reds are all there. It's a dry break. So
I think yellows look like balls.
I'd be looking at which is the simplest to pop. But of course these players she's going reds, by the looks.
Yeah, real problem red, and that's the one next to the back.
Yeah. She might even be able to manage that right now. If she takes that red close to it into the bottom left-hand pocket, she might be able to run into that red and just nudge it clear. That's important. when you're playing. You can be a very good attacking player, but
knowing when to step back.
Knowing when to step back and say, whoa, probability of playing out here is not real good, and I'm just going to leave my opponent wide open if I just keep thrashing away at trying to pot out. There, if she's made some good pull, that red comes into the bottom left hand pocket.
It's just that
red. And it goes, and she should be able to get position on this other red, this end of the table, too. If she,
that's what I said about it, just because that a bit of cue in.
Fortunately, and she, I don't know that she needed to force it that way either, because, the white had the natural angle to just go across.
And it didn't draw.
Yeah, you just cover the pocket.
And then you got the black.
Covered, yeah.
Whereas now you've just given her a lot of shots. To open the frame up.
She probably thinks this plants as well into that opposite. You saw that she must drop something here.
It looks like it goes to the pocket.
She could. Yeah, I think the red probably goes into the middle pocket. Middle right pocket, that's what she's looking at.
And now she's got to try and think if that hand goes in the middle of it. It's got to be a chance to gain more.
She might even be looking at the plant. The red onto yellow onto red. But I think that red goes directly into the middle pocket, so she's definitely playing that red we're talking about. No, she played the plant.
One shot on the top corner to pop the one corner and open the other two yellows.
I'm just going to take this one in the middle first, I think. She's missed. So both these players giving each other opportunities here that are not being taken to take a stranglehold on this frame.
And it comes down to it of where if you keep giving chances, someone's just going to take it and it might not be the nicest way of it.
Yeah, I've always had a theory. The more opportunities you give these players, the greater probability you're going to lose.
Shot harder than it has to be, just
lovely shot, went nice and clean. Barbara Taylor takes a 4-2 lead in this ladies individual semi-final, coming to you from Imperial Hotel here in Blackpool, England.
And we did say it was just a matter of who gave enough chances for the other.
And Barbara just got one chance too many, and she managed to finally capitalise and take a 4-2 lead. So this is a best of 13 frames. It's a race to 7. So this is Lloyd Clark, the referee. Back to the table. Doing his craft. We're racking up the balls. Nice black cloth underneath so that you don't finish up with indentations in the green cloth from all the racking up in the same spot.
Balls ringing, I'm surprised I don't see many of the tables with, because the I know it's only the two streaming tables have those cloths and the rest have no cloth.
Don't have it. Yeah, I think all tables should have it. Otherwise you get the indentations at that end of the table.
Especially with the amount of ball that gets played.
Yeah. So that's a timer that takes the white. I'll hand the white to the incoming breaking player, which is Anne-Marie Louise Arkle. Have I got that pronunciation correct, Leon? For her surname?
I'd have to imagine so. My pronunciations aren't that great either, so.
That's a red ball potted. And also a yellow by the looks. There's a yellow ball missing, but I didn't pick where it went.
I think it went in the middle pocket.
Right. Because the red went in the bottom left hand pocket. And this is a good opportunity. Whoever breaks, the balls are certainly breaking well. It's a question of whether they pot a ball off the break. And
give themselves a chance.
Both these denominations are well spread.
Because you need to have those chances of just taking a finisher out off the break to really start winning these matches at this level.
So that's a nice pot, taking that ball closest to the cushion first.
Now if she just drops this one in, she's got ball to the middle, ball to the corner.
It sounds elementary if there is such a thing. So she better take this into the top left-hand corner first. Starting with the middle first.
And just looking at the other score on the other table, at the minute it appears to be Sharon James 4, Amy Beecham 1.
Okay, and Amy's a defending champion, so that's a bit of a surprise, I think, for most people.
Especially with Amy winning the World Masters earlier in the week.
So she's certainly in good form. So how's Anne-Louise doing with this break? She seems to have lost her way a little bit there. Difficult part, but a bit more difficult than what she would have liked, I'm sure. And there you go, that's caused the error. And they're the sort of spreads that you would like to think that you're going to make if you're going to be winning consistently. Yeah, if you're going to be winning consistently at this level, because you're just expected to make those dishes when.
If you miss a ball by just rattling it, or you've just hit the drill in the pocket first, you can sometimes. Just missing that when you've lost the complete position of the cue.
It's
a little bit more, what have I done wrong?
So there's Barbara Taylor back at the table. She's going to try and put this red into the bottom right hand pocket.
And it's a great shot.
It's a very good shot, and the white has landed right in the middle of the busy area there. And so they can all be negotiated one by one.
And again, it's just seeming to be Anne's going game, not making. these easier finishes.
And as yet, we haven't seen anybody really take out a frame
convincing
at first opportunity.
Convincingly, as well, I think. Like, we look at the last couple of frames, both players have had chances.
Yeah. To 7, and Barbara Taylor, the number 2 seed, seems to have taken a little bit of a commanding lead at this stage in this match. It'll be interesting to see if Anne Louise can fight her way back.
If Barbara can find that breaking down speed, then all the pressure on Anne Louise Arthur.
And I guess that's what these players strive for in their practice, that they break and dish as much as possible, because this game has very much turned into the way the advantage is in tennis. When you're serving, you're just expected to win when you've got service, and that's what these top players expect.
I think it could be also a little bit of when I commentated on the Lee Kendall Darren Appleton game in the World Singles earlier in the week.
Yeah.
And I think it was 5 or so dishes from Lee Kendall.
Right.
And that's where you're just not getting the opportunities, where Darren was sat in his seat for most of the match.
Yeah.
And that's all you want to do, just keep them off the table.
Keep the top player off the table.
And an update on the other game is 4-2 to Sharon.
Right. So that's Sharon James against
Amy
Beecham, who was a number 1 seed and defending champion. And Barbara Taylor, of course, is the number 2 seed.
Well, Barbara's got a ball, so. It's a good opportunity now just to even take control of the frame.
So Barbara Taylor made her way into the semi-final with a very convincing convincing win in the quarters against Katie Martin, England, 7-2. And Anne Louise also a fairly convincing win against Alexandra Kumba, I think in Portugal, 7-3. Barbara Taylor starting to get into a little bit of a rhythm here.
Just come off the bottom row and try.
chance.
It wasn't the easiest shot, but it was left.
If you can run this truly this time.
Well, if you play these at quite a slow pace, normally down the rail they'll be accepted by the pocket, so just have to hope. But she doesn't hit too hard.
A nice pot. It's left a good limits a good angle for putting that red into the middle, because you can run through and give yourself some space for running that last red into the bottom right here.
Yeah, play the one to middle and one down the rail.
That's it.
Just try and keep the game as easy for yourself as possible. Don't have to move the cube around.
That's a nice putt, a little bit further away than what she would have liked, but this is fine. The angle's good to make the putt, and then also for the white to come off the cushion.
I think more than anything, just make sure the putt, doesn't matter if the cue rule's on the side rail, just make sure that putt.
Oh, definitely, because if you don't putt, then you just leave your opponent on to win the match, win the round. And she's played that beautifully. Well done, Anne-Louise Arkell. Give yourself an opportunity to take this frame and keep your hopes alive in this match. I'll let Barbara get right away with it. And she's played that black nicely. And Anne-Louise Arkell, to her credit, has won her third frame in the semi-final against Barbara Taylor, the number 2 seed, to trail the match 3-5 in the best of 13.
And just to give you an update, the score in the other game is 4-3 now.
To who?
Sharon James.
Against?
Amy Beecham.
Against Amy Beecham. So Amy Beecham's picked back a couple of frames, which you would expect. So the players have taken a break in this semi-final. So this match is delicately poised. You would think that what I've seen of Anne-Louise so far, I think she's quite capable of taking it up to Barbara.
She hasn't been clinical enough yet. It's only like that she still was giving chances away to Barbara that.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's what she's got to try and kill.
She's got the break coming into this next frame.
Into the ninth frame, yeah.
She could break and dish, would give her a world of confidence.
I think more importantly, just make a ball and get the choice of the best colour.
Yeah. So this is Lloyd Clark doing business with the balls.
I think what she's got to try and avoid now is a dry break, and then Barbara just being able to put her in the bad positions like she has been for the last couple of frames. And then it's mentally a much harder match to try and win it. Especially if you're dry breaking more times than potting. You start thinking about it.
Yeah, you've got problems. If you're dry breaking more than... I've seen some of the top players in the world, and these are some of the top players in the world, and ladies, but in the men it's even more critical. They start getting a bad run with the dry breaks, and it really costs them the matches.
It's like 2-3 frames later, you can be 4-5-0 down.
That's right.
And yeah. You barely touch the table.
And your confidence is broken as well. When you do touch the table, you know that you can't afford to make any mistakes, because you're already looking down the barrel.
It's pressure of every single shot you play.
Scoreboard pressure. You're watching the ladies' individual semi-final between Anne-Louise Arkell of England and Barbara Taylor. Barbara Taylor, of course, is the number 2 seed. APF live stream. Wonderful job being done by our producer in Yvonne Armitage, with able assistance from Stan Grant. She's got command of that bottom left-hand pocket.
And she's white, tight to that red.
Very tight for her opponent to do anything or take any advantage. Can she play that yellow, which is on into the middle?
She may be able to, but
it's still, a fairly awkward shot, though, isn't it?
It does look tight as well from our angle, because of how tight the white is to that red.
Yes. Get a better idea from an aerial view. So that's exactly what we're talking about. That was obviously on because she's played that beautifully. But I think the red ball here has disappeared. So she must have fouled. Yes, you can see that Barbara Taylor's quickly back at the table. And I suspect she's got two shots now and she's nicely cleared that red. So all reds are potable now. So Barbara Taylor can really take a commanding lead here.
And at 6-3, you'd have to imagine. Well, you couldn't imagine Barbara giving away four frames and not winning this match.
So, what you're saying is.
Is it watching?
Yeah, can you see a way back for Anna Louise at all? Here, this is Leon Davis, the commentary with Joe Fanto.
There's always a chance that someone can get back into a match, but it's. Is her confidence going to be there at 6-3 down against a former world champion and the number 2 seed for the event?
Yeah. You would think not, but you never know. This may be the first stepping stone. Well, it is a first stepping stone for Anne-Louise Arkin, and I would like to think it's a first stepping stone of many great tournaments to come for her.
Well, to get to this point of the tournament, you have to play well.
Definitely, yeah. So she can say that she's in the top 4 this year. That's where she's finished in the semi-finals. Well, she hasn't finished yet because this match is still well and truly alive. Barbara Taylor still hasn't cleared here yet.
She's left itself a bit awkward now. Just running out of position slightly.
Yeah, she's just going to lose her position a bit too.
But with the two visits still shouldn't be too much of a problem.
You think she might try the plat instead of the straight plat? The fact that she's lost position.
There's a chance.
Very different again, she's actually just
moved into an awkward position and put a yellow in an awkward position.
Yeah, she's with another shot to go, she's just got now turned it into two, you'll think, straight forward plates. And that's bounced back nicely. She can take that red into the bottom right hand pocket.
And she doesn't have to do really anything just to get.
Apart from play through the white to play off the cushion back for the black.
So just, this is pretty much exactly what Barbara wanted, just that chance of getting onto the hill.
Let's see how she plays this. It's an awkward bridge.
And that's a great
she's
shot.
She's played that. She's stunned out of there and left herself every chance to put this black in the middle right hand pocket and take a commanding lead.
Cut to the corner for a 6-3 lead. There it is, 6-3 Barbara Turner.
Indeed she does. She takes a commanding lead in this semi-final and was one frame away from making another final of a World Championships here in 2018. The referee's quickly at the table. The cloth is out, the triangle is out, the balls start to go into the triangle. You become a creature of habits. It just automatically puts the timer on the table.
Yeah.
And the whiteboard. Because I'd have a tendency to keep it in my pocket, I think.
I think it's just however easier they might see it.
Whatever suits the individual.
Because they don't want to have to delay the players from starting by getting stuff in and out of their pockets, maybe.
Yeah. Lloyd Clark's a very experienced referee. So, oops, a slight hiccup there. Just moved the balls as he was pulling the triangle off, but he's corrected that. Takes that glove off. They quite often take one glove off so they can feel the balls with the natural hand.
And Barbara Taylor now breaking in the 10th frame.
So, you'd think the advantage now well and truly with Barbara Taylor. She's got the 6-3 lead and the break and balls potted off the break.
And then, I thought it was saying 3 balls off the break?
And quite a spread.
There's 2 yellows and
there's 2 reds missing.
Yeah, 3 reds, sorry, and 1 yellow.
And 1 yellow missing. So she spotted 3 balls off the break. Gonna take this red in the middle. That's no problem negotiating that pot. Now, will she play the plant here? Because
I think you play the plant. Yeah, just trying to hold the white. She might be able to actually see them. Nope.
Played the plant. So he kind of lose one red, but it's still on the rail and pottable down the bottom right hand corner. But I think, unlike that, she's going to go out and dish off the break. Unlike the balls are now.
Well, it's still there.
Unless she can make this pot.
Stay in this semi-final. That's a nice shot there, just to horses there or not.
30 seconds.
Awkward bridge.
And she missed it.
Yes.
You could just tell from about halfway up the table that she just looked like it was going to miss.
Yeah, she had an awkward bridge and she didn't look well balanced. Very firm bridge, doesn't matter whether it's a standard bridge or awkward bridge.
You've got to make sure your stance is still completely perfect. And there's a nice little containing shot by Barbara, leaving what looks to be a cut into the top left hand corner pocket as we see it. But nothing easy.
Get to the black though, awkward. Yeah, it's going around the table. bridge room, plenty of queuing room. Chooses to and the blacks right in the middle pocket, and Barbara Taylor takes the match 7-3 against Anne Louise Arkell of England, and Barbara Taylor is into the final once again, chance to win more world titles. Congratulations, Barbara Taylor and Anne Louise Arkell. Leon, go ahead. What were you saying about the match?
Just saying, I think as well it's England's ladies are also in the semis of the team event.
I believe so, yes.
So it's a chance for Barbara not only to win the singles now, but the team event
also
as well.
The team. Yeah, she's been a wonderful ambassador for England. She's been playing for many years. I remember from my first visit. I won't say the year. I don't think she'd like me to say that. But it's a long time. Anne Louise, she showed glimpses of skill there, and she's made a semi-final. She's got to be proud of her achievement, and I'm sure she'll come back with a vengeance and be much better for the experience. But Barbara Taylor seemed to have that a little bit of toing and froing in the first two frames, but after that, Barbara Taylor seemed to have this match in control.
It just seemed to look like Barbara was more comfortable in the environment, whereas if you're not used to being in this kind of environment on live stream, it's pressure at the end of it.
And you'd have to say that comes with the experience that Barbara has, of course. Okay, so we'll take a break now before the next match. But stay tuned, viewers, wherever you're watching around the world, because there's lots of pool to come to you from Blackpool here in England at the Imperial Hotel. The 2018 World Championships continue.